Joined last hour by longtime hedge fund manager Stan Druckenmiller. We spoke about the markets, and Stan had a colorful way of describing what he is seeing.
I think the merging of the Fed and the Treasury, which is effectively what's happening during COVID, sets a precedent that, well, we've never seen since the Fed got their independence. And it's obviously creating a massive, massive raging mania in financial assets. And as you just pointed out, Joe, it has not spilled over to Main Street.
All right, joining us now to talk more about the markets, Paul Hickey, co-founder of Bespoke Investment Group. Paul, did you hear most of the body of Stan's comments, or is that the first you heard? Were you watching?
I heard much of it, and I think the key takeaway, and I think what every investor should be focusing on here, is to keep an open mind of things, because we don't know what's going to happen going forward. But I do think looking forward, you know, we're worried. Dom was talking about the carnage in these big cap tech stocks here. And while they are such a large weight in the market, they tend to move the market. There's a lot of other stocks out there for an individual investor. You don't have to be preoccupied with what the market's doing. You can focus with what individual stocks are doing. So you go back to 2000, we've made a lot of comparisons to 2000 here. The average stock in the year leading up to the 2000 peak was actually down and well into what was a bear market at the point. From March 24th, the year after that, the average stock in the S&P 500 actually saw a gain in that year relative. It was just the large cap tech stocks, which had such a large weight on the market. So I think going forward, what we're looking at here is to focus on, as the economy picks up steam, these large cap tech stocks that may have benefited from the shutdowns because they were the only growth in town, may see some rotation into sectors of the economy that will benefit from economic growth. And so you look at the industrials, you look at some sectors, some parts of the consumer discretionary sector, and even the financials, which were hit very hard during the initial leg down of COVID. So I think you just want to take a stock-by-stock approach and look at those things rather than just focus on the market. And unless you're investing strictly in index funds, you shouldn't be really preoccupied with what the market is doing at all.
So, Paul, I guess we do focus a lot on short term and even intermediate term. And, you know, especially this year, we talk about 2020 and everything that's happened. So it's hard to ever think about 3 to 5 years. But one of the things that Druckenmiller said was that the after effects of the Fed or even the all the congressional spending that we've seen with coronavirus and the worries about inflation and actually a tail risk on deflation as well, that it's going to make for a tough operating environment in the stock market for the next 3 to 5 years. And that we normally don't hear. We hear about the future is always, you know, where else you go but technology, and there is no alternative in fixed income. We always hear that long term we're bullish, but that didn't sound that bullish. How do you feel about 5 years out, for example?
Yeah, I mean, we're in uncharted territory here with what the Fed has been doing, with what we're dealing with the pandemic here. What's going to happen going forward? So, I mean, I think over the long term, we have had very strong returns for the last 10 years in the market, even with what we saw in the first half of this year. So history suggests that future returns aren't going to be as great as that. That being said, I mean, looking forward and over time, I think the stock market has historically provided a better return to investors than treasuries have and bonds have over time, as long as you were willing to hold for a certain amount for an extended period and not focusing on the short term. So I think for an investor with a long window, equities will certainly do better. And especially in an environment where we may see inflation run hotter than normal, I think you want to be focused on assets rather than cash or fixed income.